Okay, so here we have a regular due date property, and then we have a formula property. So in this example, we have set it to August 19th, and today's the 13th, and it shows the formula property shows 5 days remaining. And if we come over here on the due date property and select some different days, you'll see that the formula property automatically readjusts the dates here. Okay, so let's go ahead and recreate this now. Let's add a new page, and I'll just create a new inline table. And let's go ahead and create a due date property or the date property. And then let's create a formula property. So let's rename our due date property to due date. And let's go ahead and rename our formula property to days remaining. Now, in order to add a formula, let's go ahead and select the property again and then go to edit formula. It's kind of hard to see, but we can go ahead and add the formula here. I've added the formula to the description below, so just go ahead and copy and paste it. Oh, and one thing to point out is that in the formula it says deadline here, and we renamed this to due date, so just make sure that these two match. So we'll change this to due date, and then the done button should be highlighted, and click done, and that should be it. So if we set a date of like the 18th, you'll see that says 4 days remaining, 17, 16, 15, 14. So it automatically readjusts. And that's it. I hope this helps. I'll see you guys in the next one.